So thank you very much. What an amazing turnout. I mean, I'm not surprised because this is what St. John does. It comes out to support. And I want to thank, as we were talking about, as Judith said, all of the folks that turned out, the organizations, and also the individual citizens who turned out to say, I'm going to walk in the Pride Parade because my St. John is an inclusive city. So I want to thank all of you for doing that. As Judith mentioned, I want to thank the police and the fire and you know all of the organizations in the city, TD and the unions and all of the groups that came out to show their support. Thank you for that. I want to thank the organizers because this doesn't happen without a lot of work behind the scenes. So thank you to my fellow elected officials. I'm not sure who else is speaking. But MP Long, Minister Doherty, of course our Premier who's here for the second year in a row. A very busy man. So thank you, Brian Gallant, for being in St. John, New Brunswick again today. And in closing, I want to get a little bit serious for a minute. And some of you may follow me on social media, Wayne and I, and the Premier and others, all of the elected officials, we try to be engaged. I try to be very engaged in social media. And somebody posted on my social media this morning something incredibly ignorant and intolerant. And I didn't like it at all. So I gave them a chance to clarify what they meant, and they jumped in with both feet. And they told me how ashamed I should be for being in the Pride Parade today. And that they would never vote for me again. And I said, because there's young ears here, you can go online and you can read what I said back. And I asked them to make sure that they and their friends never voted for me ever again. Because I don't want people who are ignorant and intolerant and who spread hatred to support me in any way, because it's the absolute opposite of what I stand for. So I would ask you please to go online and look at my Facebook response, not to that post, but what I responded 30 minutes later reflecting on what had happened. That in 2017, we still have to go through this. We as a community have to go through this. And I'm not responding to any of this as a mayor is what I said. I'm responding to all of this as an individual. I'm not responding, and I asked my daughter's permission. I'm not responding as the father of a daughter who has a beautiful girlfriend because I should defend my daughter. I'm responding as a human being because it's the right thing to do. So it upset me. And when things upset me, I push back. And I'm not going to tolerate it as a citizen of this city that in 2017, the people are going to spread hatred and that kind of behavior in our city. So what do we do about it? We talk about it. We come together as a group. And, you know, love is love, and I want people to be happy. I had a time in my life, and I'm almost wrapped up. Sorry, folks. I had a time in my life where I wasn't being me. I wasn't being vulnerable, I wasn't being authentic, and I wasn't happy. Now I'm being me, I say what I want, I fight for what I believe in. I ask you all to do the same. Be yourselves, love is love, and I'm not going to accept intolerance and ignorance in this city, not as a mayor, as a human being. I ask you to join that same movement. Thank you very much.